My name is Dennis Malone, County President of City Council. My name is Alita Lee, and I'm the President of City Council. We are excited to welcome everyone to our celebration. Meeting programs each with graphics and some of the things. With the help of high schoolers, we are trying to come up with people who are working in these at the end of the week. You will have an opportunity to hear about the contents of the time capsules placed in the ground in October of 1972. We will also share contents that current students suggested and selected that will tell our story of what it is like to be a Swinton Lake student during the 2022-2023 school. Perhaps some of us will be invited back in 25 years to be a part of the 75th anniversary celebration.
We are excited to be joined today by several Swinton alumni and former teachers and staff members. Thank you for being here to be a part of our celebration. We would also like to take a moment to acknowledge some special guests with attendance today. Mr. William Doherty, Acting Superintendent of City Council. State Representative Jennifer Obama.
We would also like to recognize several of the former principals and assistant principals who have been such an important part of Swinton Lake's history. Please stand when we call your name. Dr. Christopher Marchese, who served as assistant principal from 2000 to 2002, and principal. Who served as principal from 2006 to 2012. Mr. Ralph Harrison, who served as principal in 2013. Ms. Kathy White, who served as assistant principal from 2009 to 2015. Michelle Britton, who served as assistant principal from 2013 to 2022. Unfortunately, Ms. Britton was not able to join us today. We would also like to acknowledge our two current assistant principals, Dr. Layton, who has been with us since 2018, and Dr. McGuire, who has been with us since the same. Unfortunately, Dr. Layton is in Texas today celebrating the high school graduation of her niece. Finally, we'd like to now introduce our current principal, Dr. Saladino. Please welcome Dr. Saladino.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you, Dennis. For kicking off our celebration and for playing such an important role this morning. I'd like to welcome everyone to our 50th anniversary celebration, those students who are here with us in the auditorium, as well as all of those students who are live streaming in through their classrooms, and all of our guests that are joining us both in person and online. We're excited to be able to celebrate today's 50th anniversary. It's an opportunity for us to look back at the last 50 years and to celebrate the history and traditions of Swinton Lake. It's also an opportunity for us to celebrate our current accomplishments and for us also to be able to look ahead at the next 25 to 50 years. Today's program consists of video segments, remarks from students, some words from one of our teachers who was actually a student here at Swinton Lake. We've, of course, got some musical selection. How about our music teachers? Let's give them a shout out. A round of applause. As you heard Dennis and Malia say, we will have a segment where we'll talk a little about the time capsule that was placed in the ground in 1972 and that was recently opened. As you came into the auditorium today, you might have noticed some of the contents on the tables outside. We'll also have an opportunity to share the items that are going into the next time capsule that will represent our time here in Springfield Lake. And finally this morning, the program will conclude with the presentation of this year's School to Watch recognition banner as a celebration of where we are as a school and all of our accomplishments in 2023. We hope that you enjoyed today's program. We're going to now begin with a video segment with a flashback to the early years of Springfield Lake, the 1970s.
My name is Matt Evans, and I went to Springfield Lake and started in 1972, the very first day of Fridays, a club meeting where, you know, various interests, whether the club be bowling or, you know, sewing or culture or history or cooking. And they had one called the Handicappers Club. Like, quite a few of us joined, which was about horse racing and learned about horse racing. And at, towards the end of the school year, we got a field trip up to the horse race track and watched races. And that was pretty cool.
My name is Rob Snaggart, and I attended Springfield Lake from 1972, the day school opened for the first time, through June 1974. During our time at Springfield Lake, we started a unicycle club. Yes, unicycle. For some reason, a whole bunch of us, all of a sudden, were riding unicycles. And a science teacher, Mr. Palmer, formed us into a club. He saw us out in the parking lot after school. We were all riding unicycles around the parking lot. And he said, "Do you want to start a club?" And we said, "Sure." And he formed us into a unicycle club. We were actually called the Rose Tree Media Hot Dogs Club.
My name is Dave Pouts, and I was at Springfield Lake from 1977 to 1980. I think the most enjoyable event we had was something called the Volleyball Marathon, which took place when I was in ninth grade. It was a fundraiser, and it started after school and went for 23 hours. So we were there from, it was 3 o'clock in the afternoon until 2 o'clock the next afternoon. And a lot of the students participated. We stayed there all night. And some of us, like me, stayed up the entire time, which was unbelievable. I remember being in the locker room trying to stay awake, taking a shower at 4:30 in the morning. But it was a lot of fun because we stayed up all night. We played volleyball. When we were playing volleyball, we were hanging out and talking to each other. And it was a nice bonding experience.
Springfield Lake opened, you might be interested in some of these fun facts and figures. On the day that the opening ceremony was held at Springfield Lake, October 19, 1972, it was actually snowing on that day. The President of the United States was Richard Nixon. The number one song on the Billboard charts was Roberta Flack's The First Time I Ever Saw Your Face. Other popular songs from 1972 included American Pie and Leon.
The Summer Olympics were held in Munich, Western in 1972. Some of my marks is broken record for the most gold medals in the Summer Olympics. USA. The movie The Godfather topped the box office as an executive. The fashion trends from 1972 included bell-bottom pants and lots of hat. The Snapple beverage company first started using this in 1972. Other products that were launched or invented in 1972 include SodaStream and the Bounce Chai Sheets. Many of the major brands in 1972 were Jennifer, Michelle, Lisa, Kimberly, Angela, Amy, Michael, Christopher, James, David, Robert, and John. Celebrities born in 1972 included Eminem, Gwyneth Paltrow, Cameron Diaz, and Dwayne The Rock Johnson. Some things were a lot less expensive in 1972. A gallon of gas was 36 cents, and a gallon of milk was 89 cents. But not everything was less expensive in 1972. The first handheld scientific calculator was introduced by Hewlett-Packard at a cost of $395. That would be nearly $2,800 in today's economy. And yes, for just over $2,500, you could afford purchased a brand new Ford Mustang.
All right, Gabrielle and Perianna, would you like to come to the podium, please? Gabrielle and Perianna were on hand when the time capsule was open. They did some video footage, which we're going to share with you, and they're going to talk a little bit about what was included in the time capsule.
On April 12th, a small group of alumni from the Springton Lake class of 1973 were invited for the opening of the time capsule, officially referred to at the time as the Memory Box. The Memory Box was dedicated on October 19, 1972. As we learned from some of the contents in the box, the weather that day was colder than you might expect for a day in mid-October. In fact, it actually snowed on that October day. Because the internet did not exist in 1972, newspaper was one of the main sources of news and information. As a result, it might come as no surprise that there were many newspaper clippings included in the time capsule. The Philadelphia Inquirer noted that Congress had adjourned and that they had fought President Nixon on issues of pollution and the national debt. The Cincinnati Reds won game number 3 of the World Series by a score of 1-0, but still trailed Oakland Athletics 2-1. The Rose Tree Media newspaper featured a story about the near completion of the swimming pool at Springton. The article required mentioned a required swimming project, but also the student handbook from 1972 included a short letter of introduction from the principal. The letter included the following. The school is designed around a team teaching program. Each grade level is broken into 3 unique mini schools, and one of our basic objectives is to know each student thoroughly as an individual. The concept of teaming at the Lake was well ahead of that of many other schools. This structure is one of the many things that has endured and grown throughout the last 50 years. The school day was a bit shorter back in the 70s, with school starting at 7:50 a.m., but dismissal taking place at 2:10 p.m. Unfortunately, many of the items that were placed in the memory box did not age well over the course of 50 years. Various political buttons and coins from the year had either tarnished or rotten. Overall, though, the alumni who participated in the opening enjoyed themselves and appeared to have fun reliving their time at Springton Lake.
Now we have our next video segment, Springton Lake during the 80s. Thank you.
My name's Jennifer Smith, Green. It's Jennifer actually Green Smith. My maiden name was Hola. And I went there, I'm going to say 86, 87, 88 to a beach. And we had to do all different projects. And we did a message in a bottle. And I threw the bottle into the water, the ocean. And a couple months later, someone had gotten it and sent a letter back to Springfield Lake saying they received my bottle. So that's one thing I really remember.
It's Jerry Gephardt, and I was at Springfield Lake from the fall of 1987 through the spring of 1990. It was probably the one that jumped out the most. We had like a Renaissance fair kind of event where people came in dressed up and they, you know, worked with the unit on medieval history. And I think one kid turns out he brought in an actual morning star. Like, it was real. I had like a ball of iron on you with spikes as a prop. And it probably put the school on lockdown today, and back in the late 80s, where it's like, do us a favor, leave that in your locker until the school's in. And next up, we've got a tribute to the 1970s with our music teachers joined by some of our talented students. Let's welcome them to the stage for a medley from the 70s.
Don't understand, then you suffer. The
Let's give another round of applause to Selena, Colin, and our very talented music teachers. Thank you. Next up, it's time to take a trip back to the 90s at Springfield Lake. Next up, let's hear from Senora Diaz, who was a student here, as you saw, and is now part of the faculty here at Springfield Lake. Senora Diaz.
And I'm here today as a former student and current teacher to kind of share my trip through the Mauritian Unity School District in Ontario, which makes me sad. In the fall of 1993, when our school had just turned 21 years old, I was a new seventh grade student by the name of Jennifer Cault. I reported to Mrs. Froggatt's her room each morning in what is now Mr. Rissett's room. Shout out to them. My Carolina accent was much more pronounced than it is now. And the only other person I knew at school was my twin. So those who heard me, students, I understand what you're going through. That's why you have a special place in my heart. It was during this school year that I made friends with some amazing people who are still an important part of my life today. At that time, no one owned a cell phone, no one sent text messages, or had a social media account. If we wanted to talk to our friends outside of school, we used our home phones, which still had cords that connected them to the walls. Just the Stranger Things. In 1993, neither this beautiful auditorium where we are now, nor any of our music classes existed yet. This part of Springton Lake, as you saw in pictures earlier, was a grassy area next to the building where we had recess time after lunch. Our current library was a two-story college-style lecture hall that served as our auditorium. Our library at that time was above the main lobby in what is now the World Language and Special Education A Wing. Ours was the only building in the district to have air conditioning, which meant that Springton Lake students had a special dress code. We were prevented from wearing shorts unless we were wearing our PE uniforms. Everyone was required to wear pants. Every classroom had a chalkboard and textbooks. Our teachers gave us worksheets they brought on the Ditto machine instead of a Xerox copier. Although it had been invented 10 years earlier, the internet had just been made available in April of that year to the public. It was brand new. Hardly anyone knew what it was or how to use it. And dial-up speed took forever. Instead, we relied on physical trips to the library to research the answers to whatever homework or projects we could assign. Electronic search engines also did not exist. We used a card catalog to look for books that we needed, and then we hoped that someone else hadn't already checked them out when we got to the shelves. Google Drive also didn't exist. Last-minute conversations with our parents the night before work was due meant our less-than-thrilled, I'm curious, parents had to make late-night trips to Deals, Staples, and Office Max in desperate search of construction paper, poster boards, and other art supplies. Though we had art, music, and PE classes, the majority of the technology-based special ed classes we now have did not exist. We learned how to type on good old-fashioned typewriters, built CD racks and stools in woodshop, and learned how to balance a checkbook and home ec. If we wanted to watch a movie in class, we had to cross our fingers and hope that our teachers had signed up one of the 5 VCR TV cards in the building. We had the opportunity to participate in many of the same clubs and sports that we do now, with one exception. Springton Lake did not yet have a softball team, so I paid for the media petticoat fee. In the fall of 2003, when Springton Lake was 31 years old, I once again entered its main lobby, but this time as a brand new teacher, freshly graduated from Penn State. I went by the name of Senorita Galt, and Senior Cutney was my mentor. I'm still thankful today for the work that Ms. Fortune gave me and helped me become the teacher I am today. It was exciting to work with many of the teachers who had taught me, and it was also a bit weird sometimes calling by the first names, and to be honest, there were some teachers that I was never able to do that with. As I had done in seventh grade, I made a new group of friends, this time from my teachers, whose support and jokes keep me going day after day, so they won worth me all of it. This auditorium still did not exist. The space in which it stands was no longer grass and recess area. Instead, 8 double-wide trailers provided classroom space, the world language, and several 8th-grade classes. School technology had made some advances. Although the teachers still used chalkboards, we also had access to backup projectors that allowed us to write transparencies and squeeze more information into the same space. We had desktop computers that allowed us to create our own learning materials, which we then printed one copy up to the classroom printer and then took with us to the copy machine that used to be in the next cafeteria behind the hangout space. If we wanted our students to complete work on the laptop or iPad, we signed up cards for our classrooms, or we scheduled time in the computer lab. Even though the internet was becoming more reliable, most of our students still relied on trips to the library to research topics. They also still drove their parents crazy with last-minute trips to collect art supplies for projects. We teachers had access to computer-based gradebooks, but our students still did not have the ability to electronically track their work and their grades. The special ed classes were pretty much the same with one exception. The typing class had been replaced with a computer lab, where students learned how to use programs like Word, PowerPoint, and Excel. And now here we are in 2023. Springton Lake is turning 51 years old soon, and we are a Pennsylvania State School to watch. I've been a teacher for 20 years, and I now know what it's like to be the veteran teacher welcoming former students back to our building. So thank you to Madam Howe, Ms. Greenmount, Mr. Wilmot, and Mr. Potts for bringing things full circle for me, and making me feel just so old I really am. Technology has exploded, expanding our local learning community into a global learning community. Our ever-available internet connection has given us the ability to learn from anyone and everyone at any time. Students and teachers are capable of learning together in person and virtually. Today we are live streaming this event for those of you who can't be here. All of us here at the lake have one-to-one access to laptops, LCD projectors, and online learning platforms. The poster projects of the past have given way to amazing interactive online presentations and videos that our segments create and share. We've seen beautiful examples of that today. In addition to a softball team, we now have a school-wide musical to entertain us each spring. A lot has changed here at Springton Lake over the last 30 years, but some things are still the same. First and most important, I'm still the same 5'2" tall that I was in seventh grade. Second, our students are still wearing the same red and gold PE uniforms, and I'm pretty sure the same things. Third, my mom is still an advocate for education and social media, and she is very supportive of everything we do here. She visits different art shows, musicals, and other events, and she's here today. And finally, our school is still a phenomenal place to make lifelong friends, to learn from dedicated and caring staff, and to make memories that will last a lifetime. It is my hope for the future that Springton Lake will continue to be a learning community that embodies the sayings every student, every day, no matter what. And I'm excited to see what happens during the second half of my career here at Springton Lake. Thank you.
Thank you, Senora Diaz. We appreciate you sharing your experiences here, both as a student and as a teacher. Next up, we have our next and final video segment, Springton Lake, during the 2000s.
Is there a specific event held that you think was really enjoyable that sticks out to you from your years at Springton Lake?
I always enjoyed the Hoops Road games. I enjoy playing in them now. It was always a fun time.
My favorite memory was probably scoring the first field hockey goal in seventh grade. It kind of started my love for field hockey.
Thank you.
next time capsule as we look ahead to the next 50 years at Sprinkler Lake.
As we look ahead to the next chapter at Sprinkler Lake Middle School, we are excited to share our next memory, Fox Time Capsule. With the help and suggestions of students in all three grade levels, we have gathered a wide range of items to tell our story of what it had been like to be a middle schooler over the last couple of years. Among the items that will be included is a 50th anniversary t-shirt, a gym shirt, a student handbook, a script from this year's musical, Shrek, a Ducks in the Fall fundraiser, a copy of Restart, our longest award book from this year, a Spartan face mask, Spartan stickers, a pencil coupon, a Spartan birthday card, and even a single donated AirPod. The time capsule will be placed in the ground somewhere on campus with a suggestion that it will be open 25 years from now, when Sprinkler Lake celebrates its 75th anniversary. Who knows, maybe we'll be invited back in 2047 to relive some of these memories.
As I mentioned earlier, part of today's program is looking back and celebrating our history, but also celebrating where we are today as a school. As you know, this year, once again, we have been recognized as a Pennsylvania school to watch. And it's my pleasure to welcome the podium Mr. Bruce Glassberg from the Pennsylvania Association for Middle Level Education to talk about this accomplishment.
Thank you very much. I'm really glad to be here to celebrate this. This is pretty awesome, 50 years. And I graduated high school in 1972. I don't remember a whole lot of what was going on when I was in this building. But I come to you as the director of Schools to Watch. I've been involved with Schools to Watch since we started actually writing the application in 2005-2006, and we recognized our first schools in 2007. I was fortunate enough to be able to go on many site visits over the years. So it's very, we're really excited to be a part of this. I want to thank the music, the band, was playing in the students and saying, I think we should give them another round of applause. Thank you. And also to recognize the student speakers. It's not easy to speak in front of their peers, and also they did a fabulous job as well. So thank you. Thank you. That's pretty awesome with the Schools to Watch celebration, but also being the 50th anniversary of the school and bringing back all these administrators that are still here. You know, that's pretty awesome, Chief. And welcome to all these administrators that have been here over the years. I actually knew a few of them since I was an administrator in a school district in Chester County for many years. But I'm really happy to be here to celebrate with you, Sprinkler Lakes, being recognized again as a school from my school. This is their second redesignation. The first celebration we ever had was in the gym at a pep rally, and then we did COVID for the second time, and we just myself and another person traveling around the state handing out banners because we weren't allowed in the school. There were no celebrations at particular year. But we're real happy to be here. And they joined one of 36 other active schools to watch schools in the state of Pennsylvania today. Over the years, we've recognized over 50 schools, but many times when schools choose administrators, either the principal or the central office staff, they decide not to be involved with this process again. So we want to thank Sprinkler Lake for again continue to be involved with this process. Because this is a three-year recognition. This recognition is based on continuous improvement. It's not just this is a snapshot of everything middle level. We just don't look at academics. We look at everything, the social emotional piece of the schools. We look at the programs. We speak to students. We meet students. We meet parents. We meet administrative staff for the district, for the school district. We observe every classroom at least twice when we come into these observations. We meet with the secretaries, the paraprofessionals, and the custodians. Because when you look at a really good middle school, the climate and the culture of that middle school is everybody is involved. And that's what's really important in great, successful middle schools. And I will tell you, There are awesome middle schools around the state of Pennsylvania. We hear a lot of things about schools today. There's some great middle schools that are doing things right. I want also to thank our sponsors. Our main sponsor of our program is the Pennsylvania Association of Middle Level Education, PAMLE. They're our biggest financial sponsor. We also want to thank the Horace Mann Corporation because they sponsor our celebrations. They've been sponsoring our celebrations for over 10 years. So we want to really thank them for that as well. I'd also like to thank Kutztown University, Penn West University in Edinburgh, and Duquesne University for in-kind sponsorships because they provide us professors to go on some of our site visits. When we come on a site visit and we do site visit training, we do school select training every summer. When we go on site visits, we bring current teachers, retired teachers, principals, school administrators, superintendents, college professors. They're all parts of these teams that come in and observe these schools, and every single one of them are based at middle level. So that's important when we look at this redesignation process. When we come back to the redesignation, we look at where they were and where they are today. So we're all, always looking at growth, and that's the important piece about it. We have schools that have now been recognized 5 times, and they always tell me that they love when they have to go back, and they look at their program through the eyes of middle level again and reevaluate the things that they do. So that's the important part of this program, and that's why we got involved with this PAMLE. It's been a tough 3 years, and you've gone through a lot of things. We're looking at some of the repercussions of COVID and dealing with a lot of issues. Your teachers have worked extremely hard. So I think you all should give your teachers in this room. I learned one thing during that, being at my age, I don't know if I could have sat in front of a computer for that period of time in virtual learning. And so I want to thank the teachers. If you give me students a round of applause, because they've been exceptional in this process of learning. This is all about relationships and building relationships, and that's so important because that builds future leaders. And you all at this school, so many opportunities to excel and be a part of a school through your clubs, your activities, your sports. Once students feel that they're connected to the school district, they can do great things. And you do a lot of really wonderful things here in the school, so I commend you for that. And it's really important in that sense to include as many people as possible. Just as a show of hands in here, how many of you that are in here are either in chorus, band, any music program, sports, athletics, anything? When you look at that, that's pretty impressive. When you look at that, that's really important. Because those programs are as important to middle level education as anything. Because some kids come to school just for some of these programs, and that's critical. And you know, that's what Schools and Watch is about. It's about middle level, it's not just about test scores, it's about the whole process of the program. So again, I want to congratulate all of you, and hope to be back here in 3 years as well. Springfield Lake was recognized first in February at our state conference, which was in King of Prussia this year in the Crown Plaza. We'll be there again next year as well in the Crown Plaza in King of Prussia. They will also be recognized down in Washington, D.C. at the end of June with all the other schools. And there are 17 states that have active schools to watch programs. So there's over 600 schools that have been recognized that are active today. All the schools that have been recognized for the very first time, redesignate 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, will all be recognized down in Washington, D.C. at the end of June. So we want to thank them for that. So this time, I'd like to present the school the banner, which signifies their designation and recognition of the school's one school. So I'll bring the banner, we'll stand right here in the front, the banner.